later on in the night, when the crowds have gone, we could talk under moonlight till dawn. We could stay to watch the sunrise, cancel all our plans. We don't need a reason why, we just can't. I wish I could stop time and stay in this moment, never think about going. Won't you stay with me for a little while? Caught myself free falling deep into your eyes. You came to me without warning, but I knew why. I wish I could stop time and stay in this moment, never think about going. Won't you stay with me for a little while? Stay in this moment, never think about going. Won't you stay with me for a little while?
God created the fish of the sea and the birds of the air and the livestock and also man. The Lord said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him." Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of the man. And he brought her to the man. And the man said, "This is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh." You may be seated. Michael and Patty have invited you here today to share this very special day with them. However, I am going to assign you a job. That job is to lift them in your prayers. Ask God to guide and direct them to his will in their lives. As they take on the task of marriage, as they are together through bad days as well as good days, through sickness and health, through all that life has for them, lift them in your prayers. Let's pray now. Lord God, our Father, Creator and Redeemer, Michael and Patty have come before you today, desiring to acknowledge you as their Lord and Savior. Lord, this afternoon they acknowledge you in their lives by partaking in communion because they want you to be a part of this very special day. Then they will make promises before you and these witnesses to each other, vowing to keep those promises for a lifetime. After that, they will be sealing those promises with a ring that will be a daily reminder of those promises. Lord, we ask that you be here with us. Give your blessing upon all that happens here today. Guide and direct Michael and Patty in their future days, months, and years, to never forget the vows they are making here today to each other and to you. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Today, Michael and Patty wanted to participate in the Lord's Supper to begin their marriage with Jesus, with their acknowledgement of the saving grace of Jesus Christ and what he has done for each of us through his death and resurrection. They would like to give you the opportunity to join them in communion today. If you would like to and did not receive a cup as you entered into the chapel today, please raise your hand so that one can be delivered to you. Today, Michael and Patty would like to share with you their personal stories and their personal vows. Michael.
My beloved Patty. At the edge of life's journey, beyond the horizon of a half century, came you, a blessing in disguise that lit up my life once again. We wove our stories together after I met you on Silver Singles. A beautiful coincidence, our paths crossed, and since that fated January 20th, my life has taken a miraculous turn. It was your laughter that filled the void in my heart, and your beautiful heart so full of love, so forgiving yet so gentle. It was loving you that made me feel like I had found my reason to live again. I remember thinking when you walked into the restaurant on our first date, I struck gold. Yes, Patty, you are that precious to me. I love your sense of humor. You said we had to meet in person so you could confirm I wasn't a 500-pound bearded woman from Nigeria. I adore your passion, your profound love of our country, and your unwavering commitment to those close to you. You have shown me that love permeates beyond skin deep. It seeps into the soul's essence and teaches us the true meaning of companionship. You taught me perseverance as you fought your legal challenges and won, setting legal precedent over and over again, revealing strength behind your humor. That time was tough, but you always emerged victorious because you are a remarkable woman. It has shown me that with you beside me, we can overcome everything. On our third date, I found myself falling in love, revisiting the buoyancy of my teenage years. You filled my life with so much laughter that even when you're not around, my heart tugs at the absence of your mirthful charm. I remember on a beautiful day in June, even before I had a ring, I dared to ask you to marry me. Your answer, PJB, was everything I could hope for. Then on September 12th, in front of the beautiful Belvedere Castle in Central Park, I made it official. I was overjoyed when you said yes, not once, not twice, but three times. Our dance lessons have been an enthralling journey, and I look forward to exploring many more moments with you. trying new dishes, visiting new places, or simply watching a movie together. Your openness to life's adventure is a joy. I pray that we continue to live each day gracefully growing in love, cherishing every step of our journey for our life together, Patty. My only dream is to experience every single moment with you. With the same excitement as a grand adventure and with a love that deepens every moment we breathe, I pray we remain healthy, and I promise to never lose the passion to keep exploring and falling more deeply in love with you each and every single day. My beloved Patty, I am blessed beyond measure to have you by my side. After Linda, I never thought I'd find love that was so profound. But then you came along. It made me believe in love again. As we set off on this journey of life together, I pledge to cherish you, make you feel loved, and remain faithful to you for the rest of our days. Patty, until I take my last breath, know that I am and always will be deeply in love with you. Today and every day, Patty, I choose you, and I will choose you over and over again, without pause, without a doubt, in a heartbeat.
Patty, you have your notes.
Oh my gosh. Was that the second surprise? Yeah. Okay.
My beloved Michael Patrick MacDonald, I've been blessed by a multitude of souls who love me and 1,000 angels who protected me, but something was missing. I thought I'd never be fortunate enough to find. No one could have guessed that sending a smile to you on silversingles.com would land me here today exchanging vows with you. That was the smartest credit card charge I've ever made. I thought I would be a bachelorette the rest of my life. I refused to trust anyone with my heart. I used to live by the motto that there were two things in life you couldn't trust, men and farts. But one glorious day, in January, I found someone who I could trust with my heart. I wouldn't trust you to fix anything in the house.
Smart. Smart.
But I trust you with my heart. My dear friend David knew that I didn't want to fall in love and find out that you were a serial killer or something like that. So when David met you, he told me that you were, in a good way, normal. While I appreciated him telling you me that you were normal, I'm still a little upset that he didn't tell you that I was normal. It's crazy how two opposites are so much alike. As we grew to know each other, I wondered how your structured MBA brain could accept my non-MBA brain and my comedic and whimsical spirit. But when my grandpa used to say, thank God not everybody liked the same thing in life, because otherwise everybody would be after your grandma. It's great. In the beginning, you told me you're not a handyman or a fixer. And I told you that I was a simple woman.
Yeah. Like quantum physics. Yeah.
But you said you studied quantum physics in college, so I was, yeah, it would be okay. Thank you for accepting my drive and my humor. You know that it's to the bone. Sometimes I have an angel on the left shoulder that says, don't say it, don't say it. But on the right one, it just blurts it out before I can stop it. You accept me as I am. Sometimes crazy silly. Sometimes uber serious, but always unpredictably predictable, Patty. I had no idea that you would be as adventuresome as you are, and I had no idea that you would have more shoes than Nike. You are the most kind, compassionate, giving person, loving that I know. You are a cross between my father and my mother, which makes the perfect person. You are without a doubt the most perfect person for me. When I saw how much you loved and cared for Mom, that solidified that I found the perfect man for me. Thank you for sharing your and Linda's mom with me. For that, I will be forever grateful. She's been such a blessing to me. And thank you for loving my dad. And help me through his passing. He loved you, Michael, and he said, that guy is a keeper. And I am officially keeping you today. We are not without scars. 1 year, this year has been full of hardship and joy. You were so patient as I was preparing for trial, playing the role of an attorney. And then you celebrated with me on my unanimous win. Your support seriously meant the world to me. My love, we are not without scars. Through different circumstances, both of our spirits have been broken, but God continues to heal our brokenness with our love from each other. I've waited for you my entire life. I want to do it all with you, Michael. Forever and always, I have never cried this much happiness in my whole life. Nor have I cleaned my glasses so much. I promise to honor you, to cherish you, and to thank you for cleaning up around me, while at times reserving the right to call you Ennis. And make you laugh for the rest of our lives. I believe God knew my heart needed you. Your simple presence makes my life magic. With you, I am home where I belong. I choose you as my husband, and I choose to live life with you over and over again.
You had him worried.
You unraveled that. Got it?
May I have the rings? Father in heaven, we ask you bless these rings. Make them a visible reminder each day to Michael and Patty and the world around them that Michael and Patty have this day come before you to promise themselves to be bound to each other in holy matrimony. Amen. Michael, take Patty's ring and repeat after me. I, Michael Patrick McDonald.
I, Michael Patrick McDonald.
Take Patricia Joanne Likens Bell.
Take Patricia Joanne Likens Bell.
In the presence of God our Father and the Holy Spirit.
In the presence of God our Father and the Holy Spirit.
I make these vows to you.
I make these vows to you.
I take you, Patricia Joanne Likens Bell.
I take you, Patricia Joanne Likens Bell.
As my lawfully wedded wife.
As my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
To hold you.
To hold you.
And to make you laugh for the rest of our lives.
To make you laugh for the rest of our lives.
I vow to respect and honor you as my wife.
I vow to respect and honor you as my wife.
And to put you in our marriage first.
And put you in our marriage first.
And no person shall come before you.
No person shall come before you.
Put a ring on it.
Patty, take this ring and repeat after me. I, Patricia Joanne Likens Bell.
I, Patricia Joanne Likens Bell.
In the presence of God, our Father, and the Holy Spirit.
In the presence of God, our Father, and the Holy Spirit.
I make these vows to you.
I make these vows to you.
I take you, Michael Patrick MacDonald.
I take you, Michael Patrick MacDonald, also known as Happy Feet.
As my lawfully wedded husband.
As my lawfully wedded husband.
What about Reagan? Hmm? What about Reagan?
And Reagan as our pup, too.
Okay. Good to know.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To love and cherish.
To love and cherish.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer, or richer.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
To hold you.
To hold you.
To make you laugh for the rest of our lives.
To make you laugh for the rest of our lives.
I vow to respect and honor you as my husband.
I vow to respect and honor you as my husband.
And to put you in our marriage first.
And to put you and our marriage first.
And that no person shall come before you.
And that no person shall come before you.
Then both together. On this day we bind ourselves.
On this day we bind ourselves.
To each other.
To each other.
Until death do we part.
Until death do we part.
Take a moment.
Here,
put the ring on.
Okay, just so.
Uh-oh.
Oh, that was the part number four. Oh, my God. Windex.
Hold your hands together there. Take a moment to feel the texture of each other's skin, the curve of the fingers, the warmth of the palms. Let these hands anchor you, not only in this moment, but all the days to come. Anchor you in such a way that when one is happy, the other smiles. And when one is down, these hands that you are now holding will automatically be outstretched in comfort and support. As you walk through life as partners, husband and wife, remember to always be grateful for the hands you now hold. Lift those hands in prayer that God would protect and guide your partner. Reach out your hands often, again and again in your daily lives. Reach out and take each other's hands in love and commitment. May your hands be forever clasped in love and friendship as your hearts have been joined here today. By virtue of the authority committed to me by the church and the laws of this state, I now pronounce you, Michael and Patty, husband and wife, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. What God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. May the Lord our God fill you with his grace and grant that you may live life together in all goodness, holiness, and peace.
Daddy, you kiss the man. Stuck with me whole your life.
Patty, kiss the man.
Yeah.
I would like to introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Michael MacDonald.
Oh my goodness, we're so touched. Hope you had fun at the ceremony. Yay! Oh my goodness. So we want to share our love story with you. And I think it started with the fact that I thought I was going to be a bachelorette the rest of my life. And I avoided second dates like the plague. So I even would make up stories like, I just changed the locks on my house and now I can't get out. So I did anything to avoid, and I know that's because the good Lord was saving me for Michael. So I'm going to pass the mic to my now ex-fiance, also known as husband.
So it all started with a smiley face on silver singles. I hadn't dated in 50 years, but when my late wife passed away in May of 2022, I saw this commercial on TV that summer as we were packing up to head up to Idaho for silversingles.com. Thought, oh, I'll just kind of tuck this away for a bit. And sure enough, in January, I thought, okay, it's time to move forward. So I spent 4 hours filling out a profile. And at my age, no games. This is me. This is what I'm looking for. And that was it. And then on January 10th, I get a smiley face. That's what the women do on Silver Singles. They send you a smiley face. And the rest is history. First date on January 20th, and here we are today.
What made you look at my profile?
So what made me look, when she sent me the smiley face, I opened up the profile. And I was like, okay, so it said she was a stand-up comedian. She was really into Second Amendment rights, so if you weren't, forget about it. Don't know what your politics are in the room, but she said if you voted for Jill Biden, forget about it.
Sorry.
And then, and then I saw pictures of her with a target target that she had shot straight through with, bullseye was shot straight out. And then she had a, I don't know, what was that thing called? That I looked like a sawed-off shotgun to me. That's what I thought it was.
No, it wasn't. It was a pistol grip pop shotgun.
So I said, okay, that's it. And then the last thing she caught my eye was, we have to meet in person, and you heard in the vows, because she wants to make sure I'm not a 500-pound bearded woman from Nigeria. So when she walked in the door, that was the first thing I said to her. I said, so, do I look like a 500-pound woman from Nigeria?
Bearded woman.
And she goes, no. And then?
And then, you know, the first date, wow. This man, first of all, he said, after you. And I thought, this man's a gentleman. And then the second date, we asked each other very serious questions, and I said, okay, so if you were writing your own obituary, what would it say? And he said, he thought for a while. He didn't just spurt it out. And he said, because that's a question I've used in when I was hiring people or anything, where it really shows someone's character, I think. So he said, I always put other people's needs ahead of my own. I thought, nah, too good to be true. The third date, I found that he always puts people's needs ahead of himself. It was amazing. What else? My dad, I have to tell you this. So my dad fell in love with Michael, and at first he had told me, I'm the only man you need in your life, so don't even think about dating. But then he met Michael, and he said, yep, he's a keeper. So Michael was with me through the entire passing of my father, which was amazing because we had been gone for a week, and we came back, and we said, my dad just wanted to, as he said, check out. And Michael said, if you're worried about Patty, Dad, don't. I promise I will take very good care of her. And he said, thank God bless you. And then that was the last that he spoke. So at the time, I had put my foot over, tried to get it over his hospital railing without my shoe on. And Michael's like, what are you doing? And I finally got it over there, and he kissed my foot. So if you see pictures of Michael kissing my foot, it's in memory of my sweet, sweet father. Yeah, I think that's it.
Okay, we're good?
We're good.
That's our story.
That's our story.
Now what?
Now we have a beautiful, special surprise from Patty to Michael.
We'll introduce the attendants in a little bit, but first I want to tell you who that beautiful voice was that sang Ave Maria. That's my good friend Jamie Teton. She's amazing. And I want to tell you a little story. So several years ago, Pete, her husband, who has an insane sense of humor, very funny. And he, by the way, if he tells you anything about me, don't believe it. he threatened for years to go on stage and embarrass Jamie by singing a song. And I love that. I love when they did it. So what we're going to do, when I found out that was actually Michael's favorite song, we're going to have that recreated. So I called Jamie and asked her to do it. Actually, I didn't call her and ask her. I called her and begged her to do it. And so here we are. We're going to sing Michael's, one of Michael's favorite songs, I Got You, Babe.
They say we're young and we don't know. We won't find out until we grow.
Well, I don't know if all that's true, 'cause you've got me and babe, I've got you. Babe, I got you, babe.
They say our love won't pay the rent before it's earned. Our money's all been spent.
Well, I guess that's so we don't have a pot, but at least I'm sure of all the things we've got. Babe, I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I've got flowers in the spring. I've got you to wear my ring.
And when I'm sad, you're a clown. And if I get scared, you're always around. Don't let them say your hair's too long, I don't care, with you I can't go wrong.
Well, put your little hand in mine, there ain't no hill or mountain we can't climb. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. Judah, hold my hand.
And I got you to understand.
I got you to walk with me.
And I got you to talk with me.
I got you to kiss goodnight.
And I got you to hold me tight.
I got you and I won't let go.
And I got you to love me so.
I've got you, babe. I got you, babe.
Everybody sing.
I got you, babe.
I got you, babe.
Here we go. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I've got you, babe.
Congratulations.
Who, amongst other disorders, suffers from oral diarrhea. It's continually running at the mouth. So we lived across from Patty in Nampa in a place we called Serial Killer Corner. She didn't tell us about all the serial killers on that block till after we bought the house. And after my wife had invited several of them in, because they wanted to help with things. But the first memory I have of Patty was her coming over after we bought the house and we were sitting on the front lawn. She sat down and broke one of our lawn chairs.
They weren't very good lawn chairs.
They were high-priced lawn chairs made of stainless steel. And she was very embarrassed, so after that I just called her Chairzilla.
Chairzilla.
Yeah, Chairzilla, and it's a true story. You've spoken enough at your wedding.
Pete says that, and the serial killer part was actually true, and I got a note from Pete that he said, Patty Bell is the only person that could write a book saying, who says serial killers don't make good neighbors?
Hi, I'm Lisa, I'm the sister-in-law, and the sister. Oh, I'm so crying, so I got this new sister here, so yay. So I didn't know I was going to go first, and they just told me, so I'm going to wing this, and it's going to be really short and sweet. Thank you, Sparkly Tornado, for coming into our life, and bringing a smile back to Michael's face. Every single person in this room loves you more than you ever know.
Hey, welcome. Thank you guys for all being here to celebrate Michael, who's my father, just so you guys can't tell. This is my dad. Patty, are you sure? I ask her that question every time I see her, so I just have to continue the tradition. 2022 was a tough year for a lot of us, you know, and I saw a couple things that year that I don't think I would ever see. And one of the two things that really struck for me was, if you guys get to know my dad, there's always a twinkle in his eye, and his damn feet don't ever stop. He's called Happy Feet for a reason, because they'll stand here and do it. If you guys haven't noticed it yet, just pay attention to these things. But when we lost our mom, those two things just diminished. It was hard to see my dad in that light for a long time. It felt like a long time. It was only a few months, but it felt like a long time. But it was when he met Patty that I started to see that twinkle come back into his eyes. And those damn feet continued to move. That right there for me was all that truly matters. You know, I thank all of you guys that are here to celebrate Michael, my dad, and Patty. I know there's a lot of people who may not believe that we should move forward, but I appreciate everybody here who's helping everyone move forward as we continue down the journey of life and celebrating this man and this woman. Patty, welcome to the family.
So the truest words ever written, I think, is that love is unconditional. By the way, since I just heard him, I am Brendan. I am Michael's youngest son. Anyway, the truest words ever written is that love is unconditional. My mother taught me that. She also instilled in all three of us boys, that it's important to dream. And I grew up dreaming about love. How someday, one day, it would find me or I would find it. But as you get older, the brightness of life can fade. And as we all know, life has a way of, you know, pulling the rug out from under you. But maybe it's love that can break our fall. I think it's very easy to get wrapped up in ourselves, in our own feelings, and in our own points of view. But if love is unconditional or absolute, our conditions have no part in it. And I think I forgot that. I think that conditions of others can cause you to forget that. I forgot to believe in love. I think that's because love hurts. But you know, love is a risk, and heartbreak never mends, but you risk everything for love because it's the only thing that can heal. Today, I'd like to think that we are in witness of that. So Dad and Patty, thank you for not turning your backs on love when life has been so hard. Because one thing that you can do that the people we lose cannot is that you can move forward and you can love. So, to Dad and Patty.
Hi, everyone. I'm Alexa, and I'm Patty, and now Michael's granddaughter. My speech isn't as long as some vows, but it's pretty long. It is such an honor to be here tonight, and it's an even bigger honor to stand by your side today. For those of you that don't know our story, I'm adopted. I'm not a granddaughter by blood, but by heart. Patty and I chose one another. I'd procrastinated getting my nails done for homecoming, shocker. And called my friend's nail tech that lived down the street. This brave lady was booked from 8 a.m. to late into the night, but made an appointment for me at 4:30 in the morning. I thought that this lady was absolutely crazy, but I was desperate, and I booked it anyway. She was late. She jumped out of her car, so frazzled, and apologized profusely, but she got right into the nail appointment. We started off with the cursory, tell me about yourself, things, but then the conversations began getting deeper. We sat and talked for nearly 3 hours while she worked diligently. She told me her long story of heartache, and we cried. We also giggled so hard that we cried again, and our time together was full of heart-to-hearts and prayers. She was heartbroken and lonely in that time of life, and tears streamed down her face when she told me about the loss of her grandbabies. She told me all about them and smiled when reminiscing on the memories she built with them. She said that she was devastated that she would never be a meemaw again, and I saw sorrow in her eyes. I felt God tug on my heartstrings, and I said, you can be my meemaw. She looked at me with love and was probably thinking, yeah, right, this girl is gone as soon as she steps out of this building, but little did she know that I'm clingy, and I was enamored by this hilarious, happy-go-lucky spitfire of a woman who loved with her entire soul. 12 years later, and she is still my meemaw and one of the most treasured humans in my life. My memories of us are precious. Riding roller coasters at Universal Studios, staying in a brothel, I mean hostel. You can ask me about that later. Our rotic dinner, that's a romantic dinner without a man. Valentine's dinner, glasses of boxed wine, construction on your salon, mudslides while watching TV, doing our nails, playing on the beach, that twinkle in your eye when you're up to something, the love that you had for Grandpa Bob.
being on television, the time you hid my selfie stick in your girdle to sneak into the Grammys, dreaming of swimming with a pack of dolphins together when I get pregnant, you teaching me to never trust a puppet, ask me about that too, a concert, and our long phone calls when you tell me about the shenanigans you've been up to. The memories abound, and we'd be here for 7 more hours if I mentioned them all. But out of all of the blessings in my life, Patty, you're one of the greatest gifts I have ever received. I'm so grateful for your love and guidance through this life. Sorry, you think I'm done, but I'm not. Michael, we prayed for you. I remembered sitting on the couch at Meemaw's old salon off of Midland, sobbing with her and praying for God to find the missing piece in her life that she was yearning for. We sat forehead to forehead and hand in hand, wondering why her journey had to be so hard. God spoke and said, "There is nothing to worry about, for I have you in my hands." He knew that you were out there and that destiny was working and slowly moving you closer and closer to one another. When I met you, I knew you were her person. I felt that tug on my heart once again. I could feel the gravity of you both, like two planets orbiting one another. The purest form of love was evidenced in your eyes and the glow that emanated in both of your souls. She was your first date in 50 years, and God knew what he was doing. She called me and gushed over just how incredible a person you were, and I knew in my heart that something special was happening. From the moment I met you and Reagan, I loved you too. It has been incredible getting to know you, and thank you for adopting me too. It makes my heart soar to hear, "Is that our beautiful granddaughter?" every time that I call you. I love you both endlessly. For the rest of your lives, I hope that you have it all. Skull be clinkum to me, Ma and Poppy.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, and distinguished guests, and fellow fans of the bride and groom, I stand today before you as the best man, tasked with the honor to celebrate the union of our dear friends, Michael and Patty. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why did they pick this guy to be the best man? Well, I can assure you, it's not because of my impeccable taste of suits or the ability to tie a perfect Windsor knot. Nope. It's because I've known Michael since the days when online dating was just a twinkle in Al Gore's eye. You see, Michael and Patty's love began in the digital realm, a place where swipes turned into sparks, emojis replaced sweet nothings, and a Wi-Fi signal carried more weight than Cupid's arrow. They met on a dating app, and let me tell you, it was like watching the real-life game of Who's Who unfolding before you. Does the date, like cats, swipe left? Does the date have a German Shepherd pet dog? Swipe right. I lost my place there. And there it was, the magical match that would change their lives forever. Now, I've been asking... I've been asked to share some of the anecdotes about Michael. And let me tell you, this man is a true Renaissance man. He can call a plumber to fix a leaky faucet, have a mechanic work on his car, recite Shakespeare, and whip up a mean avocado toast, all while maintaining a perfectly groomed goatee. Patty, you got yourself a catch. But let's not forget Michael's online dating profile that had a few quirks. His bio read, "Loves long walks on the beach." We're in Idaho, all right? "Beautiful sunsets and existential debates about the meaning of life and, most importantly, politics." Yes, Patty, I hope you're prepared for those long night conversations. And then there's Patty, our radiant bride. She's the kind of woman that can rock a power suit during the day while doing real estate and then transform into a disco diva at night for Michael. Patty, you've dazzled us with your grace, wit, and sense of humor, and I'm sure that you have the ability to dance without spilling a drop of champagne. But let's not forget how she won Michael's heart. It was during the first virtual date when Patty dropped the ultimate icebreaker. If you were a fruit, what type of fruit would you be? Well, Michael, being the philosopher, he said, I'd be a banana. Just peel me back and you'll find a sweet surprise. And that, my friends, sealed the deal. So here we are celebrating their love, a love that blossomed in the digital age, survived countless Zoom calls, and conquered the treacherous terrain of online shopping carts. Michael and Patty, may your marriage be as strong as your Wi-Fi signal, as sweet as a ripe banana, and endure the mimes you share. I would like to offer a toast to the bride and groom. May this moment be memorable, and may the union of these two people be loving, caring, and joyous for a lifetime. Thank you.
I hope it's funny enough. All right, it's time to eat. So I'd like to bless the food, please, before we start. Heavenly Father, we just are so thankful that all of these family and friends were able to attend this evening. Lord, we ask that you bless this meal as it nourishes our body, that you continually will nourish our souls. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Let's eat.
So we want to do a special tribute to a person that I never had the opportunity to meet, but I felt it was important for me to get to know through her family. This person is important to the people that I now know and love. Her name is Linda MacDonald. And she helped to mold this man into a man I love and adore. She is Michael's sons, Brendan, Tim, and Sean's mom. And she is mom for Gloria's eldest daughter. We would invite you to listen to this, to the words of this song. It means a lot to us. And to join us on the dance floor. The song name is To Know You by Lauren Daigle.
to know I live every day like it's the end. To know why I'm grateful every single minute. To know me, you would have to know my friend. To know me, you would have to know.
Write this song, so listen to the lyrics. Our story. know it starts on line. It was 50 years since my last day. You were looking for a decent man in a bad divorce's wake. Send me a smile on January 10, 2023. And by the 20th, I'd fallen fast and oh so deep. Happy days, the day we join our hands to say I do.
Love that.
Patty, do you have a couple of words?
So I just want to share with everybody a very monumental moment for my dad. So I don't really have a table, so but can you put your hand right there? I need to hold this. Can you like let go of each other for a moment? And let go of each other. There's kids in the room. Okay, but no, just put this hand up for me, Patty. Put your hand right there. Oh, other way around. Thank you. Patty, put your hand right here on top of my dad. Dad, put your hand on top. Videographer and photographer, come here real quick. Can you guys take a picture? We need to document this, but this is the last moment my dad will ever have the upper hand in the relationship. Oh, I love you, son.
I love that.
All right, we're going to play a little game here. Are you guys ready? Have you guys ever heard of the shoe game? All right, well, we're going to help you. I'm going to play the shoe game host. The way the shoe game works is I'm going to ask some questions, and there is two answers to the questions. The answer is either Michael or Patty. Michael or Patty. If you believe the answer is Patty, then hold up the blend shoe. If you believe that it's Michael, then hold up the patent leather shoe. All right, it sounds simple. Now we see how well these guys have gotten to know each other in this short period of time. Okay, first question is, who has the stickiest feet since you have shoes in your hand right now? Hey, you can't cheat. Okay, they don't stick. They don't have stickiest. They're proverbial, don't say. Alright. Next question. Who is more romantic? Ah, Michael's the clear winner there. Now tell us, who was the first one to say, I love you? And who was the first one to bring up marriage? Wow, look at that. You are a romantic guy, aren't you? All right. Well, when you guys get home tonight, who will be the first to fall asleep? All I heard about was an ambitious man. All right, who's going to be the first one to get up in the morning? For those of you who don't know, as the host of this game show, I am supposed to create controversy. And these guys have gotten every question the same, in case you're keeping count. So that means I'm the loser in this one. So let's see, who's a better driver? Okay? Which one of you is the, he said he was, he agreed with you. Which one would you say is the messiest? So if we were to look in your closet, all right. Which one of you is most likely to be running late? All right. And who's more stubborn? We are still at 100%. I haven't gotten one people who is 100%. We got just a few more questions. Who's a better cook? Who has better taste in music? Alright, that one was close. Who's a better dancer?